The 15th of October, 1990. The President of India, R. Venkatraman, receives Dr. Nelson Mandela. It is unusual, to say the least, that putting aside all notions of protocol, Nelson Mandela is given a welcome reserved for visiting heads of state. Seldom in the history of independent India has the citizen of another country known such a tumultuous and spontaneous reception. The man whose name is on the lips of people all over the world is welcomed by Vice President Shankar Dayal Sharma.
Dr. Nelson Mandela, distinguished members of the African National Congress, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure on behalf of the people and the government of India to welcome one of the great heroes of history, Nelson Mandela, to our country.
We regard this occasion as a unique opportunity to personally express our deep appreciation and gratitude to the government and the people of India. I pay tribute to the first country that came out in full support for our demand for diplomatic and economic sanctions against apartheid. India was the first country to voice the abhorrence of apartheid to the world. We salute you in the name of the African National Congress and the millions of the oppressed fighting people of South Africa. India's link with South Africa in respect of the liberation struggle thus goes back to the days of this great man, Mahatma Gandhi, whose 21 years stay in South Africa are looked upon by us as important years for humanity. With that historic background of our fraternal struggle, we are here to further cement fraternal commitment to continue till victory is achieved. Our victory will be your victory. Indeed, victory for the entire world.
Some years ago, when Winnie Mandela came to accept the Nehru Peace Award on behalf of her imprisoned husband, she found that, as in Africa, the rural and tribal folk of India celebrate the arrival of a guest in their midst with song and dance. And Nelson sees this for the first time. Nelson Mandela comes to Rajghat in silent tribute to Gandhi, who was among the first Indians in South Africa to fight against the repulsive ideology of racial superiority. As a tribute to this great leader of the South African people, the people of India decided to invite him to receive the nation's highest honor. Dr. Nelson Mandela is only the second non-Indian citizen. The first was Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, the frontier Gandhi, to receive the Bharat Ratna, the jewel of India. And even among Indians, this tribute is awarded most sparingly. It is a symbol of faith in the fraternity of humankind. Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela lived most of his life in the awesome shadow of racial discrimination. He could have chosen to live in rural isolation, but he felt so much for his people that he flung himself into the struggle for the dignity of the black people. Mandela was guided by his guru, Walter Sisulu, who encouraged him to become a lawyer. He set up in legal practice with his schooltime friend, Oliver Tambo, who, as Gandhi had done, Mandela and his colleagues fought against the pass laws, whereby every black had to carry an identity card.
It is old as white domination and colonialism has been prevalent on the African subcontinent. Ever since 1652, when the first whites landed in South Africa, one could say that the system of apartheid was introduced because it is an offshoot of colonialism and colonial domination. But in its present and most vicious form, apartheid was formally institutionalized in 1910, but in its most vicious form in 1948, when the ruling Nationalist Party assumed power. So from 1948 until now, we have the system known as apartheid in South Africa, and which, as you know, is a system of human administration in which a small white minority maintains power by force and violence and continues the brutal subjugation of the vast majority of black South Africans for the benefit of a few white South Africans.
An entire nation was virtually enslaved to enable the whites to exploit the natural wealth of South Africa, gold, diamonds, and later uranium. It was the struggle against political, economic, and social colonialism that Nelson Mandela and his colleagues symbolized. When Mandela and many members of the African National Congress were charged with treason and sentenced to imprisonment for life in 1962, even the usually low-key Times newspaper of London said, "The ultimate guilty party is the government in power, and that is already the verdict of world opinion." And the New York Times said, "The convicted men are regarded as heroes and freedom fighters." Eventually it dawned on Mr. de Klerk, the president of South Africa, that humanity and world opinion could no longer be ignored. After more than 27 years of imprisonment, Nelson Mandela was finally free. There was jubilation in many parts of the world, especially in all countries of the Third World. In India, the support for the African peoples has always been unequivocal, irrespective of the political parties to which leaders belonged. They have consistently maintained that freedom is indivisible. The Banaras Hindu University confers an honorary doctorate on Nelson Mandela, who has done so much for the dismantling of apartheid and brought about hopes of a democratic and multiracial Republic of South Africa. The city of Calcutta plays host to Nelson Mandela. He comes to Calcutta to receive the Jamnalal Bajaj Centenary Award. The special award for Dr. Nelson Mandela consists of 500,000 rupees, a specially designed sculptured trophy signifying Dr. Mandela's fight for freedom. The citation refers to the identity of purpose between the aims for which Dr. Mandela led his struggle for human freedom and dignity based on justice and equality and the values dear to Mahatma Gandhi. The people of Calcutta come out in their millions to greet Nelson Mandela. Seldom has this great city seen such a massive demonstration of goodwill and joy.
We are among our fellow revolutionaries. We salute you. We thank you. We understand that the deep regard you are demonstrating to us is also an acknowledgement of the long and close ties that bind you to the struggle and the people of South Africa. The contract laborers from India came in ships departing from Calcutta, Madras, and Bombay. The descendants of these workers, those serfs, are today very much part of the African National Congress, as are the descendants of those who came as paying passengers. Indians and Africans became the joint victims of racist oppression. Kandu's Natal Indian Congress was formed in 1894. 18 years later, in 1912, the African National Congress was born. Since then, the unity between our people has been proved in action. You are familiar with our history of struggle. The names Dadu, Naika, Kachelia, and so on are part and parcel of the ANC history. We have no doubt that we will be able to win. Nothing, I say nothing, can stand in the way of the people towards achieving their dreams. All of us will be celebrating the dawn of freedom together in South Africa. Thank you.
At the end of his visit, Nelson Mandela is in no doubt that all of the people of India hope for the early ushering in of a new society in South Africa.